So in this video, we will be talking about one more type of queue called as SQS. Why it has been introduced and what are the advantages of it over the standard queue we were using so far. So when we create a queue, it asks us that what type of queue you want to create. So we have two options available. One is the standard one and other is the FIFO. So the drawback with standard queue is that the standard queue doesn't maintain the order the producers send the message with. So if the producer is sending three messages with in order, say as 1, 2, 3, m1, m2, m3, then it is not guaranteed that the consumers would receive the messages in the same order. So this is the drawback of SQS. This can be improved in another type of queue called as FIFO. This stands for first in, first out. So this queue maintains the order of the messages with which the producer sends in the queue. How? Let's see. So I'll be creating a queue here. Demo FIFO dot FIFO. I'll keep everything as default here, and then it is created. Now what will happen if I go to send and receive messages? I have two more fields here which were not there in the standard queue. First is to tell the group ID and second is to tell the deduplication ID. So here is message 1, group ID 1, and duplication ID as 1. So I'll send it, then I've sent with the one message. I'll update it and try to send the message again, and the message is not there in this bucket. So it is reducing the duplication of the message as well. The FIFO reduces the duplication of the message as well. Whereas if we do the same thing in standard SQS, it would have sent the same message. If we want to send the same body message, we can go with updating the deduplication ID. And then we can send the message again. So this represents the unique ID of the message through which deduplication is identified. This is the group ID through which the messages are grouped into. So I can set it to 2 and as 1. And let's see if it sends again. Yes, it sends. So with one duplicate ID, it sends. So